Hello, my name is Jeffrey Colby and I want to spend a few minutes talking to you about the new Border Ballistics Technologies PMAX Internal Ballistics Simulator, which is available free to use on the website. This simulator is very similar to the well-known QuickLOAD program in that it is a computer numerical model which simulates what happens when the powder inside a firearms cartridge is ignited. To this end, there's a library of various powder types, which has the closed bomb data for that powder, the vivacity curves, the energies, the kernel geometries, and the densities for each powder type. For this demonstration, we'll use as an example the 308 Winchester cartridge with a 168 grain bullet, and we'll use a chemi-swiss powder. We'll use the RS60 chemi-swiss powder. First item to be entered is the usable case capacity, and this should not be confused with the case capacity to the case mouth, which is often quoted. The usable case capacity is the capacity behind the loaded bullet, and it is important that this is accurately entered. There's a short video in the note, which is linked to in the notes below, showing you how to measure the usable case capacity, and it's really very easy. In this case, we'll enter a usable case capacity of 51.5 grains of water, although it could be entered in cc's of water. 1 gram equals 1 cc. So if you measure the usable case capacity in grams, then you measure it as cc's of water. Next is the powder weight, and this will enter as 46.8 grains of powder, but you could enter this in grams depending on how you dress. Next is the bullet weight, 168 grains. Once again, you could enter this in grams if you wish. Next is the bullet type. This is important because the pressure required to push the bullet into the rifling will depend on how the bullet is made. This is called the shot start pressure. And the maximum chamber pressure and muzzle velocity are strongly coupled to the shot start pressure. So you can have a copper jacketed bullet, which is what we have with the 168 grain Sierra. This bullet could be mollied if you wish with a dry film of molybdenum disulfide or a smear of molybdenum disulfide grease, but in this case we'll use an unmollied bullet. Caliber is 308 Winchester. Barrel length, this is the length from the bolt face to the muzzle. In this case, we'll make the barrel length 600 millimeters, but you can measure it in inches if you wish. Case length for a 308 Winchester, 2 inches. Pressure outputs, either in pounds per square inch or bar. These are as measured by a modern piezo transducer in a pressure barrel, rather than the copper units of pressure, which would have been measured in pressure barrels typically before the 1980s, which used copper crushers to measure the chamber pressure. We'll measure it in bar. Velocity output, meters per second or feet per second. Muzzle energies can be in joules or foot pounds. The data fields have been entered. We'll press submit. On the left-hand side, we have the declared input data. You can change any of these fields and run the program again. And on the right-hand side, the results summary. Case was 93% full. The maximum chamber pressure, 2,994 bar. The bullet traveled 35.4 millimeters before the maximum chamber pressure was reached. The bullet was travelling at 836 feet per second at that point. The muzzle velocity, 2529 feet per second. Muzzle energy, 2385 foot-pounds. Muzzle pressure, 583 bar. The amount of powder burnt when the bullet exited the barrel was 86%. If the powder is all burnt with the bullet still inside the barrel, then the simulator tells you at what point the powder was all burnt. Below this are various graphs for the data. So here is the pressure versus time. We see that peak pressure was reached at just after a millisecond, and that about 900 microseconds later, the bullet exited the barrel. Under that, the pressure versus bullet travel in distance down the barrel, that's distance from the bolt face. And below that, the velocity is a function of distance from the bolt face down the barrel. So how does the simulator generate this data? Before the powder is ignited, the volume behind the bullet is the usable case capacity, which we talked about earlier, less the volume of the powder itself. When the primer ignites the powder, the surface of the powder starts to burn away on each kernel, creating a hot gas which builds up in pressure behind the bullet. The bullet does not start moving, however, until the pressure is high enough to force the bullet into the rifling. This is called the shot start pressure, which we talked about earlier. As the gas pressure exceeds the shot start pressure, the bullet starts to move up the barrel, accelerated by the gas pressure behind it. The simulator calculates the pressure due to the amount of powder which is burnt at a given time in the volume behind the bullet at that time. And then, for a short period, delta T, the simulator calculates the distance the bullet moves due to the pressure behind it. Now, due to the movement of the bullet during that period delta T, the volume behind the bullet is now increased, and also more powder has burnt during that period delta T. So the simulator calculates a new pressure at the end of that period delta T. Then, for this new pressure, the simulator calculates the distance that the bullet moves for a new short period delta T. And this carries on for successive short periods of delta T until the bullet exits the barrel. This is a curve of the resultant chamber pressure as a function of time. On the left-hand side of the curve, the gases are being produced faster than the volume is increasing due to the movement of the bullet. So the pressure in the gases is increasing. At peak pressure, the bullet is moving fast enough that the volume behind the bullet is now keeping pace with the amount of gases that are being produced by the burning powder. After peak pressure at the right-hand side of the curve, the bullet is still accelerating, and the volume behind the bullet is increasing faster than the rate at which gases are being produced, and so the pressure starts to decrease. So I hope you found that interesting, and I hope that you'll go to our website and you'll try the BBT PMAX simulator for yourself. Of course, the number of powders available in the powder library is quite small at the moment, but we'll be working hard over the next few months to increase the number of powders available to make the program truly useful. Thank you for watching.